This outdoor cooking video post is all about the spin. Yes, and I'm not talking about spin in terms of news media. I am talking about spinning on your rotisserie. I need to be very careful here because these prongs are sharp and I think I just nicked myself. But nevertheless, I carry on nonplussed. Why devote a video segment solely to a certain style of cooking that 95% of the people who I speak to want nothing to do with, okay? When I'm talking to someone about an Alfresco, a DCS, a Wolf, whatever the, you know, outdoor premium gas grill may be, and even the non-premium grills, i.e. the Webers, Napoleons, etc., usually the talk of the rotisserie is very, very brief. And it usually ends up with the customer saying, I don't want one, I don't need one, I don't care to have one, do I have an option not to have it? And it's a big mistake, because what you need to do is you need to understand what it does to the food that you're cooking and how it takes things into a whole nother strata in terms of taste. And the way that I'm going to prove that to you is by example, and something I did recently, where I made the best prime rib I've ever tasted. That includes restaurants, etc. I completely nailed it, and I did so by taking it for a spin. What I did was I decided on New Year's Day to reverse sear it again. And the reverse sear, for those who don't know, is you slow smoke something for X amount of time, and then you finish it off by searing it at a very high temperature. What that does is it caramelizes it, gets that beautiful crust via the Maillard reaction. But with steak in particular, it gives you edge-to-edge just beautiful pinkness. Particularly if you like medium rare, this is the way to go. The reverse sear is an absolute just, I mean, that is the technique to use, all right? So what I did on Christmas Day, sorry, confusing my holidays here, we did the prime rib on the Memphis grill, we slow smoked it, and then we took it off for about 10 minutes and cranked it, and then got a nice crust on it for about 10 minutes, cut in, it was great. Slightly undercooked in my opinion, but it was all good. For New Year's Day, I said I am going to bring the rotisserie into the mix here, and I completely nailed it. So we went on the Kamado Joe, okay, for about 2 hours or so. So that's cooking the prime rib on a ceramic cooker at a relatively low temperature, it was about 250. We pulled it off, okay, and I allowed the muscles to kind of relax. So now instead of searing it on the grill at a high temperature, I brought it over to the alfresco. Now, normally what would I do? Just turn the burners up, the infrared burner, the solid fuel insert, and just crush it at a very high temperature. But I said, no, I'm gonna do it differently. We're gonna use the rotisserie, because with the rotisserie, I have the back burner, okay, the rotisserie burner, which is infrared to assist with that caramelization process. But I could also use the burners down below in a variety of ways. So on this cook, I actually had three different styles of burners going while the prime rib was spinning on the alfresco. So we had the back burner, right, the rotisserie burner, infrared hitting it. We also had the burner underneath it at a low temperature, very, very low, okay? And then what I had, and this wasn't really about cooking it, it was more about flavoring it. I had the front-facing urban fusion system, or their quote-unquote smoker burner, on the alfresco. It's right here. Can you see this? There it is. I loaded that up with wood chips because I knew that it wasn't going to assist in the cooking process, but I wanted to imbue that prime rib with some more smoke. And we hit it with some cherry smoke for about 45 minutes, unbelievable. So let's just get the visual here, right? I've got the alfresco 42 going, I've got the prime rib spinning on it. Oh, there we go, take a look at the pictures. All right, we got the IR burner in the back on, okay? We have the burner underneath. Actually, you know what, it wasn't underneath. I had a burner to the side, to the far right that was on at like, you know, upper lows, let's just say. All right, just enough to give it some heat. And then I had the burner, and there's a dedicated burner on the alfresco smoke infusion system, urban infusion system, whatever you want to call it. There's a 5,000 BTU burner over there. I have that one going as well with the cherry smoke, cherry wood chips. Well, what I noticed was I gave it about an hour, was checking it out, and what I noticed, and this is the reason why you have to love the rotisserie. When you do the rotisserie, in essence, what is happening, whether it's a chicken or it's beef or whatever, you know, pork loin, whatever, the beauty of the rotisserie is that the spinning motion allows the fats and the juices to actually, it will self-baste the piece of meat. So the moisture and the flavor that you're getting from this are completely unparalleled, because if you do this on a grill, you know, your drippings are going somewhere. They're leaving the surface of the protein and they're either hitting the grates and going down to the burner and disintegrating. You'll probably get, you'll get a flare up and a smoke, flavor kiss, or as we call it. But or if you have a drip tray underneath it, you'll catch the drippings in there. And I guess you could use it later for a jus or something like that. But the fact that the protein keeps on spinning, okay, and you see the moisture running off it, but it's not really coming off of it. I mean, some of it is, but for the most part, it is just self-basting. And by the way, if you do this, okay, you must have a drip tray underneath it, because I don't care whether it's chicken, it's prime rib, whatever it may be, those drippings that do come off the spinning protein, okay, are going to ignite. All right, and you're gonna get massive, massive flare-ups. I actually have a video about how I nearly blew my Alfresco grill up. You can go look for that one, because I was doing the rotisserie without a drip tray. So drip tray is very, very important. But anyway, we took the prime rib off after about an hour and a half, maybe a little bit less, an hour and 20 minutes. And I gotta tell you, it really knocked the living, you know what, out of the one that I made on Christmas Day, where it was just smoked and then reverse seared on the grill surface. Having it spin completely brought it to a different level. And I am on record saying, I might have done a video about this as well, I certainly did a blog post, is that the best chicken I have ever tasted was one that I did on the Kamado Joe a little short while ago with their Jotisserie, where we're fire tissing, okay? We have the rotisserie spinning over the coals, all right? So you're getting that direct, you know, live fire cooking. All right, without a briquette system or anything like that on a gas grill, you're getting that live fire while the bird is spinning. That was completely out of this world. I wanted to do that with the prime rib. I was actually looking to get the Alfresco solid fuel insert underneath it and spin the prime rib that way. I've made chicken that way before, which was unbelievable. But the problem was with the bone was going to hit as it spun. The bone was hitting the solid fuel insert because it's high, so I wasn't able to do that. But nevertheless, I am a devotee of live fire cooking, and I, where there's a will, there's a way. We'll find a way to do it on the Alfresco. But the moral of the story is that when you do your outdoor kitchen or you are buying a grill, and I don't care whether it's a Weber and going all the way up to the food chain, please do not poo-poo the rotisserie. You have no idea what you are missing. It does not take much work to get involved with this thing. I mean, my gosh, if any of you have had the Costco rotisserie chicken, you know what I'm talking about. The stuff is otherworldly. So do yourselves a favor. If you have a grill and you haven't broken out the rotisserie, use the damn thing. And if you're shopping for a grill, don't poo-poo that. You come here, we'll set you up with all the right information. If you're going to another store, make sure that you have a rotisserie on that unit. You know how to use it. Ping me, jonathan@curtos.com, if you have any questions. Remember, these grills, the majority of them, we ship them all over the country, free shipping, all right? Nationwide shipping, folks, so we'll beat any price out there. So give us a shot. Even better customer service on the follow-up. This is our 70th year in business, so you're gonna be hearing a lot about that. If there's any questions, jonathan@curtos.com, or call us, 914-793-5600. Let us help you realize your outdoor cooking dreams. Thank you.